Hello everyone, welcome back to PJ Chen Design. Today we're going to talk about how do I get into this really flowy form, look like it's done by T-spline, but no, just bare bone Rhino. Are you ready? Let's get started. So the idea for this form is from one of my YouTube subscribers sending a couple image, more of architecture, look like a jewelry. As we can see, this form, it's a continued piece right in the middle. It looks like I have some sort of curve on the top and some sort of curve on the bottom, and it can be done by loft. So let me show you how I draw this line correctly into those three sections. Let me starting with the circle here. So we're gonna have a circle right here, and I'm going to cut it out the same angle. So it's easier when the center is right at the 0, 0. You can have a different opening if you want to. I'm just gonna eyeball it roughly about this angle. And we can also change it later. By using those two, I'm going to trim the bottom off. Okay, so that's acting one of the circle there. Let me go ahead to move this circle down, become like this. Okay, and then we need to have this circle repeating. So I'm going to using the polar array, and let's put the center as a 0, and let's do three of them for 360 degrees. Okay, so that is that. We also need to have this arc coming over here, right? And again, it's hard to know like exactly if I am doing the symmetrical, so always starting with the circle. If I just do the arc, it may not be 100% correct. So I'm roughly going to get something look like this. And I'm gonna coming over here and draw again a straight line, roughly something like this. Have this one mirror to the other side, like this. This time we want to pick the shorter one, so let's go ahead to trim the longer one here and here. Okay, so now with this arc, it's not in the right position. We need to move it over here. So let's go ahead to use the rotate tool, set it up the center right at the 0 right here, and we want to rotate it somewhere along here. So the degree I am looking for is 360 divided by 6. So I'm gonna type it minus 60, so that will be right there. Okay, and let's do a test and see if this is the curve that we are looking for. I'm gonna use the blend tool, and we are going to blend from here to here, and that gives us some adjustment we can do by changing those and or changing those to find whatever you like. If you feel like this is too tall, you can change it, and I'm going to stay with something like this. Now I'm also going to do the same thing on the other side, and then you will get something like this. And you can start take a look on this one, because we could have those very simply just polar array center with the 0 and polar array 3 times 360 degree, and then we get something like that. Again, everybody gonna come up something slightly different and see how you like it. Right, and then if you don't like it, for example, we're gonna go back one more step, and then we can have this one going more of like bigger or smaller or close or whatever that you are going to like. Alright, so I did a little bit adjustment. I find whatever shape that I like. Now they are in little section, right? In order to create a continuous form, we need to have them become one single curve. If you just join it, let me explain to you what is the difference between just joining and after that you rebuild it. Here is a curve that we have. And then I draw that, and I'm going to draw another curve right here. Alright, so those are two curves, and if I join them together, it looks like they become one single curve, right? But what happened is, if I have that curve, and then I try to extrude it, so let's go to the surface, we want to extrude this curve, going top like this, alright? It looks like nothing is wrong, but look, there's a seam right in the middle, and how do I know? You can tell that there's a harder, darker line over here right at this point, right? If I turn it into the black one, it might be easier for you to see. Now you see that darker line. That means I can explode it. This one become two surface, and that's because there's a join over there, right? And then you can also join back, and you will say, PJ, what's different? What's the differences between this one and continuous piece is because now if you look at the property over here, it say open poly surface. That means you cannot edit with the control point. When you try to turn on the control point, it says cannot turn on the control point for the poly surface where on the command bar. All right, so how do we fix this? Let me do one more time. We have this curve right here. We want to do rebuild. Once we rebuild, you see the number bump up so much from 9 to 45. It's because it tried to trace every single curve as possible to match that original one. If you keep it as a 9, and you can see that the curve is changing, right? It's everywhere is changing, and here is the largest deviation over here, so it will show you your curve is changing. We try to keep it as same as possible, but we don't want that big number, so let me try 20 there. It's nice to have it like something like this. It's not too much of a difference, and then we click OK. All right, so now we're gonna do exactly the same thing. We're gonna go to the surface and extrude the curve straight. All of a sudden, you see a very uniform surface, and you can turn on the control point on this one if you want to. So that way, you can edit it if you want to. So let's go back to what we have here. Since we want to do the editing, we need to make sure this is a single curve as possible, right? So let's go ahead to do a rebuild. In the rebuild command, right here, you can see all the silence become like so weird shape, so we need to bump up the number. If we bump up the number close to whatever it had, then you're gonna have 63 point and it get it really really close. All right, or you can reduce the number and see how much is of a difference that, and if you still like it. So I'm going to stay with the same number as it suggests, and we're gonna click OK. So now we got the new curve over here. So that's our curve. We're going to create another curve right here on the bottom, right? So let's take a look for some experiment. I'm going to bring this one up with those two curves. Let's give it a try for the loft. We're gonna loft from here to here. And make sure that they are aligned. In this case, it's really hard to see they actually are aligned. So I'm going to move this to the quadrant and move this to the quadrant or possible quadrant over here and make sure they are facing the same direction. Okay, so now we have them aligned. Let's take a look on this. All right, you will get something like this. Doesn't matter what option that you choose from, they all look the same. It's because we have two curves, right? In order to get different type of curve, that you need to have a third curve in the middle. Okay, so we're gonna stay with this and we're gonna click OK. All right, so this is really not what we're looking for because we want the body is a little bit puffy. Okay, so I want to rebuild this surface, and for some reason it doesn't let me rebuild. And if I look at this, I do have the two seam there, and it's weird because I already rebuilt the top and shouldn't have the problem. So what is the problem? The problem is actually the bottom curve, right? So why is that? Let's take a look on this bottom curve, and we want to put it on rebuild. Notice that the count is the same, but degree is 2. So that's a degree 2 curve. Even that we have a degree 3 curve on the top, that is still not gonna work. So we need to make sure that we can stay with the same count, but we want to make sure that it's a degree 3 curve. Then I will click OK there. All right, so we're gonna go back and do again, and I intentionally to show you this because some of you may facing the same issue and you might ask me. So let's go to do the loft. we're gonna go from here to here, and again we want to make sure that they are aligned to the same place, facing the same direction, and let's click enter, and then let's click OK. So now we only have one seam there, that's a good sign. Okay, if we want to turn on the control point, those are the points that we have. You can try to see if it work. Let's go ahead to select everybody, and we're gonna do the scale. So using the gumbo, holding the shift and drag it, and then you will get this bowl looking things. Okay, now if this is the shape that you want, and you can go ahead to offset the surface, we're gonna set it the distance for 1.5, and then we are going to make sure it's not solid, and this is what we get. You want to watch out this no folding. Sometimes like this, you are folding into itself. It could be the potential issue when you try to print and it tell you the error, and then the whole piece is solid. I'm sure that you have that experience, right? So sometimes offset is a great tool, sometimes it's not, especially when you offset something with the larger distance. So this is what I usually will do. Instead of doing the offset on the surface, I'm always like to offset for the curve. So let's go ahead to do exactly the same number. So we're gonna offset distance for 1.5, and this is what we get there. We're gonna offset this one again for 1.5, so this is what we get there. I'm going to change the color to the red one so it's easier for you to see. Alright, so instead of doing the offset, we are going to build the surface one more time with the loft. So let's go ahead to do the loft from here to here. Make sure they are aligned. So we're gonna snapping into the quadrant, to the quadrant, and make sure they are the same direction. Okay, so this is what we get. Let me turn into the red color. And not only it is intersect, you notice that the surface is a lot more complicated, right? So let's go ahead to turn on the control point, and we're gonna do the same things, and then we are going to scale it up, something like that. Okay, so now let's double check there's no folding. It's really nice over there, there's no folding on the top. So this is good to go. All right, so now we need to create, we need to cap both top and the bottom. You can use the cap if you want to, or you can use the blend tool. If you use the cap, it's going to be flat, right? So we're gonna pick up the first edges, second edges, and we click OK. Then it gives you this kind of like bumpy surface, and then you can change it, say you want a higher, lower, or whatever you like, right? So this will be the surface, and once again make sure that it's nothing is twisting too much over there. You can change those options over here and see what kind of result that you get. But if it does has the twist, you can always change into the sweep to rail. Okay, so that is one. We also wanted to do the bottom one, and then that is two. So once everything is done, let's go ahead to join them and double check. It says close solid polished surface on our property. Many of you been watching my video in the past year and been really supportive to writing the comments. I would like to ask a lot of you for a small favor. It's no cost to you, but like and comment and share my video. That's going to help the small YouTuber like me to grow up my channel. And that's the only way I can keep going to produce more video. Thank you for watching. I will see you next time.